I'd like to introduce Hamid Iliev from ERSC, who's going to talk about EO services from research to business.
Good morning, everybody. My name is Hamid Iliev, and here is Tusimiwari to the previous speaker. First, I'm representing another European institution, as European Association of Remote Sensing Company. And I am from Bulgaria, native. And Ioana is also from Bulgaria. And we can say that today is Bulgarian contribution to the force from the south part of Danube. Congratulations to our Romanian hosters. We have very good and fruitful cooperation with them for years. And I think that one of the key points for success of any initiative, and more than for the open initiative, is regional cooperation, especially for the country in Europe. So, shortly I will present ERSC. We will give our vision for the value of Earth observation, how we support business from research to business solution, and of course I will stop to the open source initiative, which is one of the key points of activity of ERSC, and how we are working in the region. So, about the ERSC. ERSC is the European Association of Remote Sensing Company. This is membership-based, not profit, Brussels-based organization, which was created 13 years ago. And Ioana speak about the ESA, forgot to tell that most of the program which she presented is for the European company and for the member of ESA. ERSC full membership can obtain European company, which represent from European Union, and from ESA membership, which mean not also European Union, but Canada, Switzerland, and Norway are member, full member. We have also, how to say, observer members. And observer members is a lot of company who are not company, because the second main restriction is to be company. Not NGO, not non-profit organization, etc. But we have this option in our statute of membership, observer membership, and there is number of entities which are representing different space sectors domains, which are not from Europe and also not legal company. So, and of course, with 13 years, our organization, which is significant, how to say, anniversary we spent this year, and we have members from 22 European companies. It's a very nice picture. I will ask to remember the phone of picture for the end of my presentation. What is remarkable here, that you see the big, how to say, vendor on the space sector as the Harris, which is American company, and this is because Harris has European entities, as Airbus, and which is very famous for us, for example, for the winner of the Earth Observation Company of this year was The Planet. And I'm happy to congratulate Robert here. This means that Europe is the example of the openness and the freedom. And it is the same in the space sector, and I think that the most open space sector in the world is European market. So, more than 7,877 employees, more than 500 companies, and more than 1.2 billion euro revenues. Remarkable is these diagrams where the biggest part of our members, it's SMEs. SMEs is the core of the European space Earth observation industry. And I think that I will come back to these questions again in the end of my presentation. So, also the trend of the prospect of the Earth observation business in the last 10 years, ERSC is doing number of significant surveys from 2006 to 2016, you see three times. And also 2.5 times is the growth in the employees which is doing in Europe. So, very quick about the Earth observation service value chain. Here we have the ground satellite operator, and data reseller, and this is their chain, and you see in the old picture that this is the biggest, how to say, portion. Of course, the second is the open source and GIS software, and the smaller part is value adding for Earth observation, but smaller and important because we are delivering to the client the final products. Final product is not software, is not data. Final products is really this value added contribution which is given from Earth observation to fulfill the end user requirements. So, what is our mission? To support growth of sustainable Earth observation service, and I think that we are doing this very well. The rank of ERSC is very high. We have very, very successful relation with the European Space Agency. From last year, once per year, we have the board of director together with the representative of the European Space Agency to fit and to discuss how and when and which kind will be supported European industry to go further and faster. Also, we are a service, Earth observation service can be applied to many areas and economic activity, but still it is infancy in the terms of real commercial use. We are here, stay in the big gap with what is the real situation on the market in the USA. And government still is the biggest client, more than 50% on this market. And of course, this is something which should be changed in the next programming period of the European Union. What we are doing, we are organizing and we are doing this chain between decision maker, industry and the user. We are represent our members. We try to make to produce to show the value of the Earth observation to the end user and to the decision maker. Of course, we are working with different activities to develop market, and of course, we are promoting industry through the different tools. So, one of the first initiative was Earth Observation Magazine, which is issued more than 15 years, I think. Which is sector magazine with very, contributive presentation and information about the SMEs. The second, it's of course, is a brokerage site about the Earth pages. Wiki portal, which is the new initiative existing for 2 or 3 years. And the oldest, this was the first, real contribution of the Earth observation industry to the real sector. It's an oil and gas Earth observation portal, which we maintain more than years. I told you, and one of the significant contribution of support of ERSC to the decision maker in the European Union and ESA, it's a survey of the European industry, Earth observation industry. Oop. So this is what we are doing on the international level. ERSC is very active in the GEO. We establish and we just for the last year we provide three mission in the Latin American with the Japanese and also in Africa. We are working with the biggest technology organization and European ACES, and of course we are partnership with the end user organization as the NEROS, EURISI, which help us to deliver it to our members real trend of the end user requirements, which is key for the business, and especially for the SMEs. This is the, for the big companies, they have the big departments which make this survey, analysis, etc. But when the company is 3 to 5 people, how you can organize this? So, the value of Earth observation. Since 2016, 17, once the Sentinel was launched and the system was fully complete and workable and operational, we start to try and to think how we can help to industry, and the best example and the best solution was to make value chain, examples of different sector, economical, environmental, social benefits. This was organized through different Sentinel case, which is was done from ERSC, and here is very sensitive topic which our members know. ERSC as secretariat develops some projects, but only and exclusively in the area where there is not competition with our members. This means that we are doing consultancy project, we are doing survey project, we are doing this what need our members. We don't try to enter us in the field when the company could be present and they can take the benefit. So first project was first three project was winter navigation of Finland, forestry management in Sweden, and where is the infrastructure monitoring. It was very successful. It was very high level assessed from the ESA. This project was funded as the example, as a case of opportunity which give the Sentinel free data to the end user. And after that there was next projects which is coming. It's ice navigation in Greenland, growing potatoes. And what is important, these two projects, they are not ESA funded. It's a fully customer project which was taken from the customer association, I think in the European Farmers is here and also here. And there is some short cases which we are calling. It's a peatland management of UK and dredging in the Maldives, I think. So how is working the, what is the value chain methodology which we use? This is given what is the real benefit which can be obtained through using, which is very important to show to the decision maker and to show to the end user. Danish Meteorological Institute provide daily maps for the ice condition, especially for the Greenland. 800K is the benefit which is taken from Royal Arctic Wine, mainly due to the optimization of the MI maps, optimization of data workflow, using free of charge data with Sentinel. Second, the main contribution is 2.7 to 3.6 million estimated. About the another sector as the shipping, which is concerning local fishery, transport, etc., which save time and fuel to operate in this condition. The third, it's a business and walkaway company operate, which saved also time for the traffic in this period. And of course, the biggest, it's a geopolitical, strategic value of the, this winter roads for the Greenland. Total benefits, we are estimating between 8.6 to 12.5 million. I told you this was the first and very successful project which was given for the Baltic Sea when was optimized the winter winter navigation through the using of Sentinel-1 satellites, and primary benefits of course it was icebreaker, but also you see here the another beneficiary, cargo ships, ferries, oil tankers, coastguard, ports and harbor, and of course citizens and walkaway economy, economy by foot and in the shops and all other suppliers. Yeah, here you can find more info about these four cases. Supporting research to business solution. This is one of the big challenges toward the European Union now, and ERSC is trying to be in time with this political, decision of the European Union. And one of our ideas is how we can support really our members, which, as you saw, are most small and medium enterprises, and how we can support to speed up research initiatives and to support researchers and innovators to access more relevant maturity products. We introduced the concept exploitation readiness level, which reflect to this level of maturity which small and medium enterprises company develop as their R&D products. And of course, this will reflect to maturity of the technical solution, business plan, exploitation roadmap, marketing material, successful demonstration, and successful safe. This is the conveyor belt of the whole process of all life cycle from idea to business plan to marketable product, commercialization, exploitation, and all this belt we are supporting now throughout the several projects where ERSC participate and try to deliver to the commission and to the decision maker requirements from one side from the industry and from another side from the decision makers. So different support for different user, knowledge support, capital support, technology support, and market support throughout all life cycle, which is from idea to the end products. So, as I told you, all this we supporting with execution of the real projects. Here is the five key projects which is executed now from the ERSC as the secretariat. One is FIRE, which provide to the potential user point how to enter in the sector, organize animate community, promote cross-sectoral exchange, and promote industrial capacity. Second project, this is the PARSEC, where we tried to play via this project as the non-profit accelerator, which is, I think, is the first time when non-profit organization is working as accelerator based on the money which we receive in the project. You see, there will be selected 100 proposals, and they will get 10,000 euro to develop their idea. After that, on the second time, 15 of them will get 100,000 euro to develop and to support. This is great support, and I can tell you that this is really motivate the European industry, and we are thinking how to, maybe to, not to limit, but to think how we can manage when we will be 200 members in the association, because it will be still very large organization. E-Shape, I thought that ERSC is very active in the GEOS and GEOS initiative. We have amazing good relation with our friends from USA and with Barbara and with another, which very often we exchange the information, make joint seminar. And I think that Europe, and especially Sentinel and Copernicus program, is one of the big contributor now to the GEO. We promote, this is formerly EuroGEOS project, which will showcases. I'm not very familiar, but I think that it's more than 50 showcases which will be developed in the frame in the project, and again to present what will be the benefit from the. Okay, here is one of the core our initiatives which we took, and the retail market. We built and we create this project EOMOL, which is practically the same as usual MOL, only for Earth Observation Company. And you can see here the first member of the MOL, which present their product, as each shop which present their product and services in the MOL. And the idea is to stimulate and to develop the European market and the usage of the satellite data. The next, the last but not least project, it's we are very careful follow the trends of the European Union. This is OCRE. We are thinking and we are working now how to merge initiative between high performance cloud computing and Earth observation. And of course, this is supported also from European Union with 9.5 million budget. Okay. About the open source, open source initiative, I told you that we have been the first non-profit organization which create the working group. We very high assess the contribution and the capacity of the open source. Now we re-establish this working group, and I hope that in the near future we will have the second presentation and our vision how to develop the open source software in the frame of ERSC in the region. We are trying to be active here. There was a big project GeoCradle which investigate and analyze the Southeast Europe capacity for Earth observation, geospatial company, and open source. And of course, we are promoting different events which will happen in the last 2 years during the Bulgarian presidency, during the Romanian presidency, together with ESA and another. So, my last provocative question, what is the future of the Earth observation? And here is the questions, maybe it's too bloodthirsty pictures. No. This is synthetic fish, but as you see, this is cloud fish. And this is first. Second, this is open. And the real blood and the real, how to say, oil for this fish is the open source software. I am more than 13 years in the business of Earth observation. I remember the first European image processing machine, Pericolor Numa, like maybe nobody from you know, which start with RMX systems, which nobody know at now at the moment. And this was so expensive, so tough, so heavy systems that compare with now with the open source initiative, we are in absolutely different, how to say, millennium, which is true. And I think that to avoid that this is too bloodthirsty pictures, ERSC is playing significant role. Why? Because we are managed relation in the fish quartz. And we are managed very successful relation in the this fish quartz, which presented for the 30th year, we achieved significant contribution of the members and representative. Okay, this is all from my side. Thank you.